Hello, welcome to SDT University. I am Dr. Sangeet of Faculty of Naturopathy and Yogic Sciences. Today we shall study on Introduction to Chromotherapy, the Historical Highlights, Definition and Applications of Primary and Secondary Colors. Now we shall study what is chromotherapy, the definition and historical highlights.
What is color therapy? Color therapy, also called as chromotherapy, is a method of treating ailments by using colors. The therapy is done by shining an appropriate color on a particular area of body. It is also done through eyes by looking at a particular color. Though this is performed with utmost care so that there is no strain on the eyes. Color therapy is a complementary therapy in alternative medical care. What does color therapy do? Color therapy is a non-invasive and holistic treatment that brings balance and health to your mind and body. The vibrations of color in color therapy class improve your mood and overall health. What is the basic idea of color therapy? Color therapy are made of reflected rays that hit our retinas as the wavelength vibrates. Our brain interprets these wavelengths, which ultimately makes our perception of color as a physical and sensory experience. Color therapy is based on the idea that colors create an electrical impulse in our brain, which stimulates hormonal and biochemical processes in our body. These processes either stimulate or calm us. Now we shall see the definition of chromotherapy. Chromotherapy is a technique of restoring of the imbalances by means of applying different types of colored lights to the body. History of chromotherapy. Some 2500 years ago, Pythagoras applied color light therapeutically. Color halls were used for healing in ancient Egypt, China, and India. The pioneer of modern chromotherapy was Niels Fensen of Denmark in 1877. He studied the possibility of assisting the healing of wounds with visible light. Dr. N. Pankhurst, right? Blue and red light are light and its rays as medicine in 1877. Edwin Dwight Babbitt wrote The Principles of Light and Color in 1878. In 1933, Dinsha P. Gadiali explained why and how different colored rays have various therapeutic effects on organism.
Now we shall study how colors can influence our daily life.
How do we see colors? The inner surface of our eyes contain photoreceptors, specialized cells that are sensitive to light and relay messages to our brain. There are two types of photoreceptors: cones, which are sensitive to colors, and rods, which are more sensitive to intensity. You are able to see an object when light from object enters your eyes and strikes these photoreceptors. Some objects are luminous and give off their own light, and all other objects can only be seen if they reflect light into your eyes. However, humans can only see visible light, a narrow band of electromagnetic spectrum, which also includes non-visible radio waves, infrared light, ultraviolet light, X-rays and gamma rays. In terms of wavelengths, visible light ranges from 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer. Different wavelengths of light are perceived as different colors. For example, light with a wavelength of 400 nanometer is seen as violet, and light with a wavelength of about 700 nanometer is seen as red. However, it is not typical to see light of a single wavelength. You are able to perceive all colors because there are three sets of cones in your eyes. One set is the most sensitive to red light, another is most sensitive to green light, and third is most sensitive to the blue light.
Now we shall study what are primary and secondary colors and their effects on our body.
Color therapy. According to the action and effect of various color on our body, the colors are divided into two groups. One is primary color and second, secondary colors. The primary color consists of red, blue and green, while the secondary colors are orange, violet, yellow and purple. Now let us quickly see what each color could do on our body. First, we shall go into the primary colors. First, we shall see what red color can do on our body. Red color brings warmth, energy and stimulation, therefore good for energy, fatigue, colds, chills and passive people. Red energizes heart and increases blood circulation. It builds up blood and heightens a low blood pressure. Energizes all organs and senses the hearing, smell, taste, vision and touch. Increases sexual desire and activity. Stimulates ovulation and menstruation. Never treat cancer with red because this color will stimulate their cell growth. Generally, red color stimulates and excites the nerve, activates the circulation of the body. Red acts as an counter irritant. Some of the diseases treated with red color are anemia, bronchitis, constipation, paralysis, physical disability. Red color should not be given in anxiety, fever condition, hypertension, inflammatory conditions such as swelling. The next color we shall go into, yellow color. Yellow helps to strengthen the nerves and mind. It helps to awaken mental inspiration and stimulates high mentality. Thus, it is an excellent color for nerves or nerve-related conditions or its ailments. It also energizes the muscles. Dark yellow soothes the pain in the nerves, that is the shooting type of pain. It is excellent for nerve and brain. Stimulates the cleansing and eliminative action for liver and lymph nodes. It purifies bloodstream and activates lymphatic system. Diseases treated with yellow color are constipation, indigestion, kidney problems, diabetes and hemorrhoids. Yellow color is not given in fever, diarrhea and acute inflammation. Next color we shall go into the blue. Blue is cooling, electric and astringent as per Dr. Edwin Babbitt. According to his text, The Principles of Light and Color, which states that blue ray is one of the greatest antiseptics in the world. Blue is generally known to promote growth, good for sleep, increases metabolism and builds vitality. Also reduces the nerve excitement. Some of the diseases treated with blue color are insomnia, chickenpox, cholera, epilepsy, and some of the conditions where blue color should not be given are cold, rheumatic arthritis, paralysis, etc. Now we shall study about the secondary colors. As first, we shall go into orange color. Orange is warm, cheering, non-constricting. Orange has a freeing action upon body and mind, relieving repressions. Orange shows new possibilities and other options in life, stimulates creative thinking and enthusiasm, helps to assimilate new ideas. It is also helpful in dealing with excess of sexual expression, stimulates milk production after childbirth, also maintains blood pressure, maintains calcium metabolism of the body and also strengthens the lung functions. Some of the diseases treated are hyper and hypothyroidism, menstrual cycle ailments, gout and also diabetes mellitus. Next we shall go into the next color, that is green. Green is the color of nature and earth. It is a balance and harmony in essence and possesses a soothing influence upon the both body and mind. It is neither relaxing nor astringent in its impact. Rain can be used for just above any condition in need of healing. Generally, it gives the effect of cooling, smoothing and calming. Acts on the sympathetic nervous system. It is emotional stabilizer, pituitary stimulator. It is sedative, muscle and tissue builds up. Some of the diseases treated with green color are bronchial asthma, bone disorders, heart conditions, insomnia and digestive disorders. Next, we shall go into indigo color. Indigo is great purifier of bloodstream and also benefits mental problems. It is freeing and purifying agent, parathyroid stimulator and also thyroid depressor, respiratory depressor. It is homeostatic. Some of the diseases treated with indigo color are bronchial asthma, nose disorders and bronchitis, and also pneumonia. At the last, we will see what are the actions of violet color. These are colors of transformation. They heal melancholy, hysteria, delusions and alcohol addictions and bring spiritual insights and renewal. These colors slow down an overactive heart, stimulate the spleen and white blood cells, that is, increases immunity, brings sleep, soothes the mental and emotional stress, decreases sexual activity, decreases sensitivity to pain and also helps in detoxification. Leonardo da Vinci proclaimed that you can increase the power of meditation tenfold by meditating under the gentle rays of violet as found in the church windows. Violet is known to stimulate the spleen, cardiac depressor and also purifies the blood. Diseases treated with violet color are bladder diseases and kidney problems, skin complaints, epilepsy, tumor and rheumatism.
So today we have learned on introduction to chromotherapy. The next time when we meet, we shall explore more other topics on chromotherapy. Keep learning, keep growing. See you next time.